Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm showing you all my favorites and dislikes from Shop Miss A. There's not a lot of dislikes and I do have a lot of likes. So I couldn't do a top 10 or a top 20 because I don't have enough for 20 and I don't have enough for 10. And so I'm just making it my likes and dislikes. So there's quite a bit of likes. I do use a lot of these products on a daily. Everybody has different preferences, and so not everybody's gonna have the same opinion as you. These are just my opinions. These are the things that I like or dislike from Shop Miss A. Yeah, so I'm just gonna keep it nice and simple, quick. I don't wanna make this too long. I have a lot of stuff here, so let's just get in here. So I'm going to start off with a dislike. So the first thing I'm going to start off with are these Silly Dip Wonder Blenders. I didn't really care too much for them. I used this red one when I did. I'm using all new products that I'm showing you, not the products that I used, just to keep it so it looks nice and you can see the product as it is. So this is what the blender looks like. It's really nice and soft, but for me, it was too soft. I don't like something that's so soft when I go to use it. I literally have to pinch the whole blender down to blend it into my face when it is wet. Now, if you just dampen this with, you know, a spray bottle and use it, it might not be as squishy, because it is a little bit more dense when it's dry. I didn't really care for it. This side, it did, you know, pack on a lot of foundation without taking a lot of it, which is the point of the blender. But I just didn't really care for the soft side. I do like to wet my blenders every time I use them. So I don't know, it was kind of a fail for me. Maybe not for you. You know, like I said, everybody has their own opinions, and you know, maybe somebody else, you know, liked it and liked the softness of it, but I'm just not a fan. They also had the teardrop looking ones as well. So we're just going to put them over there. I'll probably be giving the ones that I have extras of away to people, you know, in giveaways and stuff like that. All right. So, like for me from Shop Miss A is the Zuri Flawless Contouring Palette. If you've been following me, you know this. It's my number one go-to palette for contouring and sculpting. This color is really great for sculpting, you know, the contour. And these I don't really use too much, which I'm going to go into this next product with my likes and just put these together. But this is the pressed powder, but I use it as my contouring color, and it is just very, very pretty. This is the palette, but it's just a really soft brown color. It just goes onto my skin real nice and gives me that soft, subtle contour to my face. And I love it. And it's only a dollar. I'm pretty sure these are sold out, but you can still find this Zuri contouring palette. I recommend everybody get it. It's only a dollar and it's great. My favorite is this color right here. I have probably like six of these. I probably have more even stashed somewhere in my drawers. So I don't know. I'm just a fiend of this contouring palette. I don't know. I'm yet to find another palette that makes me want to switch. But I haven't really tried any palettes, so I don't know. I did have the Tarte Princess Contouring Palette, and that was my go-to, but I found this and switched immediately. So if that tells you anything, yeah, this is a really good, good palette. And also all the Zuri finishing powders are really, really good too. I really love Zuri. It's my favorite brand from Shop Miss A, and I will represent Zuri all day. Okay, so the next one I have here is this No Pore Primer. My skin is very, very oily. So when I get a No Pore Primer, it's not going to work for me because it's very oily. So then when you go to put on your foundation and you're noticing that it's not sticking to the skin, that's a problem for me. So the first time I used this, I did a video on it. I think I did. I'm not sure if it's still down there, but I did use this and I went to go put on my foundation and it wasn't sticking down. I was having like patchy spots and it wasn't pretty at all. You know, somebody else might like it. Somebody with really dry skin might like this stuff, but not me personally. Not for me. So that's a no-go. The next one for me has to be the AOA Studio Pressed Highlighters. And they're awesome, okay? Like, this is my favorite. It's called Eris. It's a really pretty, like, white color. And it's kind of the dupe to, like, Jeffree Star. But it's super, super pretty. And the color just is bright, okay? It's no different than the color I'm wearing right now on my face. It's the same exact thing. I do recommend you guys check out the pressed highlighters. Very, very good. I use this every time I do a shot, Miss A. Love this highlighter. Okay, so a don't for me next are the AOA Studio Lip Makeup Remover Pads and the Eye Remover Pads. I bought these a while back. I didn't really care for them. They're real oily and greasy. I bought these a long time ago and I still have them and they're still like wet. Have you guys ever used like wood cleaner or old gold and you get it on your hands? That's what it feels like when you get this on your hands. It has that like just, I don't like it. I don't like it. I tried it. I used it probably 2 years ago and I still have this from 2 years ago. I've kept them only because they're Shop Miss A and I, you know, I always have to keep everything Shop Miss A, which I have storage where I keep all my Shop Miss A stuff. So this is in the vault with all my things. Not a good for me. All right. And the next one for like is this is the Malibu Glitz 3 Eyebrow Powder Kit. I can barely read the stuff on there, but it's cool. It comes with this wax, which I don't use, but I use these. I usually start with the dark color here, and then, you know, in this area, I always use the light color. This is how I do my brows. I use this, and just to do another like, I use the AOA Studio Slim Brow Pencil for my eyebrows now. I am starting to reshape my eyebrows, so I'm growing them back out. As you can tell, I'm trying to get them a little bit more thicker, a little bit more curve on them. So I've been using both of these to get this. It works out really well. And then, which is with all my brow things, is the eyeshadow primer. This is by Amuse. And this is the blank canvas, and I use this with my brows as well. It is my favorite from Amuse. Really good. These three is how I get these brows. So if you're wondering how I do my brows, I use these three products from Shop Miss A to do so. So those are my three likes, which got that out of the door quickly. We're going to go to a dislike. And I'm just going to throw these two out here, the AOA Studio Wonder Baked Highlighters and Eyeshadows. Not a big fan at all of anything baked, okay? I know that I have the Laura Geller Baked Powder to Foundation, but that stuff is really, really good. But this stuff is not all that great. I find that you have to kind of rub kind of hard to get anything out of there. And you barely get anything compared to the pressed powder. It gives you more of a softer glow. I rubbed pretty hard to get that much. So, and it looks really chalky like. And it doesn't sit on the skin quite as well as the pressed powder does. So not a big fan of the pressed highlighters and the pressed eyeshadows. I'll show you this one. And this is kind of like a gold color. It just comes off kind of not very bright and just kind of chalky. I like the pressed powders. I like the mattes and the shimmers. I'm not digging the baked. I'm just not. I don't know why. Not my thing. Next thing I have here that is a like are the AOA Studio Perfect Setting Powders. I have every single one of these. I have the banana powder, the matte translucent, I have the soft light, and the brightening. And these are really, really good. I recommend you all get them. They're the best. I use the translucent more than I use anything because I really like to, you know, get the highlighted parts, and that works really, really well with the translucent. The next dislike for me are these dewy cream highlighters. I'm not into anything cream really, so I'm not a big fan. I'll do this one. It doesn't really go on too bright either, but that is a highlighter, and that's in the shade Wink, and this one is in the shade Opal, and it looks like that. I'm just gonna go like that and put it there. You can't really see it. So yeah, that is that. That is a no-go for me. Okay, and then the next like for me is the Amuse Cosmetics blush. I have different ones of these, but I only found this one with all my stuff. But this is a really, really pretty color. It is my favorite color. Just a really nice kind of mauve-y color. It's called Dusty Rose. I love this color. It's the color I'm wearing right now. Sometimes on days that I just want to put on a little light makeup and run out the door type thing, I use this for my eyeshadow and also use it for my blush, kind of as my contour type thing, and then add some mascara and a little bit of liner, and I'm done. I don't really do too much when I'm doing kind of a quick, but I really love this Dusty Rose, my favorite go-to. Actually, all these Amuse Cosmetics, the new blushes and these round ones are pretty good. So those are a thumbs up for me. Alrighty, and another don't for me is this Amuse Cosmetics Tinted Brow Gel. Not a fan. I put it on once, ruined my whole brow. I was not happy. It comes out real thick. You can see it. It's real goopy. It just was real watery. And not happy at all. Super mad. Had to redo my whole face because I use this for my brows. Luckily, I didn't have my whole face on. I just had my foundation and my concealer. So I only had to wipe that off. But this is a no-go for me. I don't recommend it. Don't waste your time. The next yes for me is the AOA Studio Wonder Blender, and this is the pink beveled, and I love this sponge. It is my favorite sponge from Shop Miss A. I use this over using my Real Techniques sponge. I will pick this up way before I touch that sponge. This is my favorite. This is the pink beveled. It has the really nice sharp tip there, and then the beveled to really get your foundation into the skin really nice. And I use this side sometimes to do my sculpting like that. It's just a really good blender. It's the perfect density for me. And when it's wet, it's that nice cushiony soft but not too soft with a little bit of hardness in there. Perfect sponge. Recommend it. The beveled pink sponge. If you guys do not know, it is the Wonder Blender by AOA Studios. Love it. I need to put a new one out anyway, so that's going to go into my new one, and this one's going to the trashola. All right, and then another dislike for me would have to be the AOA Studio eyeshadow primers. I just don't really care for them. When it goes on a little bit cakey for me, and I don't really like that. I don't really like how it's real cakey feeling and a little bit oily too. They have other eye primers like the one that I just showed you. That's by Amuse that work really good. It's really thick, so I would be sparing with it. Some things that are cheaper, you have to be different with it. You gotta work differently with it instead of caking it on there like some products where you can just put it on and then it just blends right into the skin nicely. This is not the case with this, okay? So it just I feel that it just sits on top of the skin. It kind of creases and it's more like an oily base, so it doesn't stay into the skin like it's supposed to. A no-go for me. No-go. This Clean Slate Primer. I know people have not seen me use this, but I am in love with this Clean Slate Primer. It smells so good. I will literally use this just so I can smell that. You'll be seeing me use this a lot more in the next few weeks in my videos. It's really good. I really like it. So I do recommend the Clean Slate Primer. Smells amazing, people. And this is what it looks like when it comes out. Just a really thick, kind of creamy type primer. Just really nice. You could tell it's nice and hydrating. Oh, and it just smells amazing. Good stuff. All right, and then there is another don't for me, which is the AOA Studio Skinny Underlining Mascara. I think these skinny mascaras are a waste of money and a waste of time. They don't get a lot of product on them. The applicator on them is not very thick, doesn't have a lot of things on it, little spoolie things on it to pick up much of anything. The primer one is about the same. It's, to me, just kind of pointless. So going into one of my likes that are kind of similar to this would be the Fat Lash and the Fat Lash Mascara. I do recommend these two. It is really good. I use these every time I do a Shop Miss A video most of the time. But I just find these two kind of pointless. Don't waste your time. Just buy these. It works way better. You get a lot more product, a bigger applicator on there for, you know, application. And then this is the mascara. You will want to kind of hit that top off. But it's really nice kind of, you know, full applicator there for the mascara, and they work really good together. I really, really want to try this AOA Studio Pre-Lash, but I haven't used it yet, so I couldn't put it in this video. I'm waiting to get the mascara that goes with it, so whenever I get that or that comes back on sale, I can maybe review that in a video. But yeah, so I recommend the Fat Lash. I just don't recommend these skinnies. They're kind of pointless. I haven't even used them. I think I used it one time and found it pointless. So I use the Fat Lash and the Fat Lash Mascara. Good stuff. A don't for me would have to be this Sculpting Brow Pencil. It is not my favorite. Once you get that tip kind of where it's not like a crisp tip anymore, it gets really hard to get a really nice fine line on your brow. So it's not my favorite. When I first started shopping with Shop Miss A, I picked this up because it was the only brow pencil they carried. So, you know, it's in my collection. So the spoolie is really good on it. It has a really nice thick spoolie there. It does work. I don't know. I don't like them. So that's a no-go for me on the brow pencil. You know, maybe somebody else might like it, but I do not use. Once they got those slim brow pencils, this was finito for me. Gone. So that is a no. Don't waste your time. Just get the slim brow pencil and call it a day. The next do for me would have to be this hydrating mask. It is, you can find these under the Zuri brand. You can look up hydrating masks and this will pop up as well. It looks like this. So if you're wondering what that looks like, it's really good. It smells like cake. It is probably one of my favorite ones from Shop Miss A. I love it. I don't use the oils. Your body produces enough oil for you. You don't really need to add all that. Maybe some to the tips of your hair, but you don't need all that oil in your hair. No, but I love it. It smells amazing. If you walk into an ice cream store, that's exactly what this smells like. It's so good. It's so good. So this is a buy for me. Get it. It's good. Good stuff. Another yes for me would have to be these Wisp mascaras. These are super awesome. And they come in 4 different colors, the blue, the green, the brown, and then the black. And these are just really good. The applicators on them are just amazing. And the colors are so bright and just beautiful. And I used the brown and the black already. I just haven't had a look to where I needed to use these. So I haven't used them, but they are really good. There's a brown color with a brown look is just beautiful. But yeah, so these wispy mascaras from AOA Studios, amazing. Love them. Recommend them. Good stuff. Alrighty. And the next don't for me would have to be the AOA Studio Buttercream Gel Eyeliners. They dried out really quick for me, so I didn't really care for them. It still comes out just a little bit, but like I said, I didn't really care for these containers much because they just dry out super fast. I probably used it once and I didn't really care to use it again. I did really into going to a dupe, these loose pigment AOA Studio eyeshadows are just beautiful. I have almost every single one of these, so I do recommend those. So I don't have any more dislikes. I mean, I'm sure there's something out there that I do dislike, but a lot of the things that I buy 90% of the time I like, so I'm not gonna have a lot of things that is like a dislike for me. I'm gonna move on to these 3 foundations from Shop Miss A. I'm just gonna keep it in the foundation category and show you my favorite foundations from Shop Miss A. And this is the AOA Studio Powwear. And this is in the shade Fair Ivory. I mixed this with another shade. I can't remember what it is. It's in my bag. But I just grabbed this out and I love this foundation. I didn't like it the first time I used it because the color on it was crazy orange kind of looking. But I added a different color to it and it made my shade the perfect color and I was in love with it. So I do recommend the Powwear. It's awesome. Good stuff. And the Buildable Satin Foundation. Now, if you don't like this, you should really think about adding it to this. I've had a few subscribers even mention it that they really liked the 2 combinations of these 2 put together, and they are a really good combination if you're not really into kind of a, because this is kind of watery base. So if you're not really into wanting like watery type foundation, but kind of a thick watery foundation, you mix these 2 together and it makes a great, great foundation. And if you're not really happy with one, mixing them, you might, you know, be happy with the 2 together. And then my next favorite, this foundation, I was the first foundation I bought off Shop Miss A because they did not have the AOA Studio foundations when I started buying. And this Santi Flawless Perfect Finish foundation was my go-to. It is really good. You can't really get it anymore on Shop Miss A. It is very thick, as you can see, and it's just a really, really good foundation. I just love it. It goes on the skin beautifully and sits on the skin beautifully. This was the first foundation that I started with, and when I started doing makeup, and I love it. I have probably 3 bottles of this, and this one I had recently got. I got lucky and they had restocked and I said, oh my God, I gotta grab that. But it is just beautiful and I just love this foundation. Shop Miss A, you need to restock this. Get a hold of Santi and get this back in stock because it is good stuff and I would order it immediately. So my favorite foundation. I love it, but you can't get it no more. So it really, really sucks. My favorite lash from AOA Studio are the Terry lashes, and these are just gorgeous. They have the perfect spacing in between, and they're just very, very pretty. I'll open them up so you can get a better look at them. And they're just really pretty. And if you can see, they have some that kind of stick up in between the ones that are laying down. So it gives you kind of a curve, and then it has one that's curved under. So it gives you kind of a layer. And the name of these are Terry. Really, really pretty. My favorite. All right. And the next thing I have here is the AOA Studio brush cleaner. I love this brush cleaner. It is so good. I still use it to this day. I still have one in my drawer in here. They look like this. Really, really nice. And it's just a little itty bitty. So when you're doing it, you just real fast on your, set it back down. Perfect. And you can take it out, clean it, and put it back in there. Put the lid back on and just stick it back wherever you need it to go. Really small, nice for traveling and keeping in a little small makeup case. Just perfect. And it is my favorite. And I have one right here in my drawer that I use every single time I do my makeup. So I recommend the AOA Studio brush cleaner. Really, really good by AOA. Love that. Okay, and the next thing I have here is the AOA Studio Perfect Finishing Powder. This is in ivory. I love the pressed powders from Shop Mazay. They're really good for contouring too. You can get the lighter shade and sculpt with that, and then contour with a darker color, which would be beautiful. But yeah, so I love the pressed powders, AOA Studio, really good, recommend those. I also recommend the AOA Studio Paw Concealer. This stuff is so good. I love it. I recommend it. Comes out really nice and thick, and it just sits on the skin really nice as well. Just a really pretty concealer. It's real creamy, just easy to blend. Here, I'll get a blender here and just kind of show you how it blends fast. It just blends in the skin so nice and sits on the skin just beautiful. That is that all blended in. You can't really see it now, but it just really just covers up all that. You know, you can't even see my veins anymore. It's really, really nice. Here's the difference. If you want to see the difference in that, see all my veins there, and you can't see them on this side. Just a really, really good concealer. I really love it. I got some in a darker color so I could use it as a contour as well, because it's just that good. The AOA Studio Liquid Concealer, recommend that. Another do for me is the AOA Makeup Remover Wipes. These are in watermelon. These are my favorite. I hate watermelon, like I've said, but these smell so good. I continuously buy these ever since I ordered them, because I wasn't even going to order these, but I just wanted to try them out, just the smells, and give you guys kind of a review for it. And I turned out really liking these, and they're my favorite now from Shop Mazay and or from AOA Studios. They work really, really good and get the makeup off really, really nicely. So I recommend these. They sell out fast, so if you're going to pick these, go and grab them. Let's hope they're still in stock. The next two are kind of a similar type of thing. They're both from AOA Studios, and this is the Sugar Fix and the Jelly Jam. These are so good. It has those little itty bitty beads in them, which help scrub your lips. And this is the Sugar Fix, and this is in peach, but this stuff is awesome. I use this right before I do all my cleansers and all my face creams and stuff like that. I'll put this on, and then after about 2 minutes of having this on, I will rinse it off and then put the Jelly Night Mask, which is so good. I love this stuff. The next day, my lips are just so soft and just perfect. These two together, when you use this and then put this on after, it's amazing. Recommend you pick those two up. The next yes for me, which is a contour, and this is a Sculpt FX, and this is in the shade Chestnut, I'm pretty sure. Yeah. And I love this for contouring. This stuff is great. It does go into skin nice. It does really kind of blend nicely to give you that more of an airbrush type look. It is just a gorgeous, gorgeous Sculptor contour. Love it. I recommend that. And this is in Chestnut, like I just said. All right, and I have three things here and then we're done. So the next thing I have here is by Away Studios, and this is the Renew Exfoliating Facial Sponge. And it looks like this, and you just put your two fingers in here. This is what I do. You put your soap on your face and then you get this nice and wet and you scrub your face, get all the insides and stuff like that. I really love using these after, you know, when I have a full face of makeup on. These are so good. It scrubs your face really good. They have them in black and then the pink. They're just really good. And you just stick fingers right in there and scrub away at your face. It does really, really nicely. And I stocked up on these. I have a bunch down in my drawer. I have the pink and black ones because I do use these regularly. So they're really, really nice and they last for quite a while. I wash mine off, so when I use it next, it's nice and clean, so I can use it longer. Totally recommend this. It's really good for exfoliating the face. Really good. The last two things I have here, this is by AOA Studio, and it is the Sugar Lip Scrub, and this is in Honey. I really recommend these. This is really good stuff. I used to use this before they came out with the Sugar Fix Scrub, but this is really good. I recommend it. Really good stuff. They have all different flavors, so you don't have to just get the honey. So that's a good one. And then the last thing I have here, this is by AOA Studio, and it is just a face massager roller. I use this every day. I just use this to get the blood flowing and stuff like that. It's really, really good. It's only $1, and you can definitely feel it working and pulling the skin when you use it, because it has that like angle on it. It really does pull the skin. So it's really good. I like it. Alrighty, so that is everything in my likes and dislikes from Shop Miss A. I will leave my link down below. So if there's anything in this video that I did like that you want to purchase, or even that I dislike that you want to purchase, I will leave that link down below for you. And if you have any questions, or you know, you're having trouble finding something that you're looking for, please leave me a comment down below and I will help you as soon as I can get to you. And yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe. Alrighty guys, I'll see you on my next one. Bye-bye.